First of all, the rate of growth in cloud, how is it performing and how are you winning new clients?
Thanks for having me, Caroline. So we're really excited right now about the growth that we're seeing coming from the cloud and coming really from digital transformation. When I was on Bloomberg last quarter, I had the pleasure of talking about the growth we're seeing in industries from aerospace to agriculture. This quarter, I'm excited to share that momentum continues across everything from making candy to counting the beans and shipping everything in between. We have major announcements with Hershey, with UBS, with Maersk, and the growth continues to be super strong.
What do you think the likes of UBS, Maersk, as you mentioned, are really seeking when they go to Microsoft for cloud provision? Is it cost efficiencies? Is it the use of the AI? What's really the unique selling point here?
So there's a lot of things driving digital transformation, from changing how customers engage with their customers in different ways, to how they empower their employees, to how they actually transform their own products. If you take Maersk, for example, what we're really excited about what they're doing there is they're leveraging Azure to reinvent the entire supply chain by connecting containers, the 17 million containers that they ship across more than 1,000 vessels, connecting them with IoT sensors so that they can build artificial intelligence models for better guaranteed delivery of their products for their customers, and saving tens of millions of dollars at the same time. So there's a huge growth being fueled by greater efficiencies. And at the same time, it allows them to enter new markets. We're actually partnering with Maersk now to take their software assets, put them on our cloud, and enable them to reach new markets and new customers through the same. So it's greater efficiencies, product transformation, top line revenue increase, and bottom line efficiencies.
Is this something that uniquely only Microsoft Cloud could provide, or is it something that competitors could, but they just don't have the legacy software already within these businesses? What's setting you apart?
Well, what we're seeing is that when enterprises choose to go to the cloud and choose to truly digitally transform their businesses, they're choosing to partner with Microsoft. If you take what's happened with UBS, they've chosen to move their risk management solutions to Azure, not because it's just a motion of moving their assets to the cloud, but as the largest manager of wealth in the world, to them, it's critical that they choose a partner that operates in more regions than any other cloud provider, and that chooses a partner that adheres to local data sovereignty and security laws. So the investments that we've made in particular for the globally systemic important financial firms are in fact actually what's fueling the growth in financial services. And so we've announced relationships with UBS, with Visa, with MetLife, and with Geico, and we're really seeing it fuel a differentiation for our enterprise growth.
Are these enterprises ever moving off AWS, off Google, to Microsoft, or are they already customers of yours?
Well, so many of these customers have been Microsoft customers for many, many years. And in fact, it's the trust that they have with Microsoft in the enterprise space that leads them towards choosing us as their preferred cloud platform when it comes to their most important workloads. We see it as a multi-cloud world. We think customers will dabble with our competition. But when it comes to building new businesses, truly digitally transforming, establishing new product lines, they want to go with, frankly, a partner they trust, and one that they've trusted for many years. And so many of them are choosing Microsoft as their enterprise cloud partner.
And what about the move to a hybrid cloud? Because many companies have been slightly concerned, maybe more risk averse towards moving purely to a public cloud. You're offering a hybrid stack coming in mid-2017. Is that a real area of growth for you?
It's a massive area of growth for us. In fact, in hybrid has been a big part of our strategy for many, many years. We see customers needing to leverage hybrid cloud technologies because the first thing you have to get right in any of these digital transformation scenarios is to get your data estate right. And so if you operate in a highly regulated industry or in many different parts of the world where the public cloud may not be appropriate, the notion of leveraging what you have in your data center and coupling that together with the public cloud to serve up a better offering is in fact what we see customers doing today. So the deep intellectual property investments we've made in on-premises technologies for many, many years and the same code lines that we leverage in the cloud allow customers to leverage hybrid cloud with one common investment frame. They can write once and deploy anywhere with the Microsoft public cloud.
And so looking at the competitive landscape, AWS, owned by Amazon, is the number one player. You've got Google saying that they could see their cloud being bigger than their search part of the business. Where does Microsoft see its cloud part of the business going?
Well, we're really excited about the momentum we're seeing right now. And to be clear, we are 2 minutes into a very long game right now. We like the momentum we're seeing, certainly in some of the biggest growth industries and the biggest markets, from financial services to global trade, in the relationship we've announced with Maersk, to aerospace, to the connected car. Enterprises are choosing Microsoft, and we see that as a huge competitive advantage that will fuel our growth for many years to come.